We're going to start the table assembly. To start the table assembly, we have to start with the motor first. It's going to be hard to mount this motor later, so we're going to put it on first and go from there. First thing we have to do is put your carriage bolts in here to start. And this is going to be your surface you're going to work on, your public surface. You need to put that down on cardboard. You want to protect it. Now your motor has rubber insulators. That's nuts to go on the bolts. Nice. Now after we have the insulators and the bolts on, next is to set the engine, the servo motor, rather not the engine, in place.
A certain way it has to go?
Well, we don't want to tighten it down. It can only go one direction, the way the holes are re-drilled. You're going to leave it loose so you can line up the belt later. You're going to pull it up here and try to line it up as best you can with that hole. And when we get everything on there, you'll have to do the finish line up. We're going to put it on there and kind of snug it, but we're not securing it. I'm going to put a washer, a lock washer, and a nut on each one of these. We're going to snug this just slightly so that motor doesn't rattle around until we're ready to make the adjustments. We've loosened it again.
Bob talks a little fast, so.
I'm a little excited. Yep. It's not my sewing machine, but it's all the same.
He's excited for me.
The K-leg has two pieces, and we're going to put those together now. And then put it on the table. We have two of these.
They just slip together, cool.
Yeah, they slip together and then you put the bolts in.
So that'll need a final adjustment as well, because that's your height, right?
I'm just snugging.
And since I'm short, it's probably... Wow, that's a lot of hardware.
Takes the short bolt, the washer, and a nut.
So how do you know which one goes where? I mean,
well, you don't need a long one here. The long ones are obviously for another place. You're going to use the shorter ones.
Oh.
This is the bolt size that I'm using for the legs. So I got the bolt, washer, lock washer, and then the nut.
Sarah.
We're going to put the other K-leg together, and then we'll get to the mounting bit. Now we got the K-legs put together. We got to measure for 28 inches because my wife's short. You may have to measure up to 31 inches depending on how tall the operator is. My wife is 5'3", so you may need to make the adjustments from there. So we're going to get the cross braces on next. I measure 28 inches like this. The big bolts here were 19 millimeter if you needed it now, and the small ones are 17. May have more bolt sizes to come. I'm going to make a minor adjustment here. Since we didn't have the benefit of instructions, it doesn't come with it. I looked at this, and this sharp edge up doesn't seem to make sense. So we're going to flip this and put it back together. Now on the foot pedal, I've already put in the bolts with the Phillips head. This slides back and forth for adjustment. We may need to make adjustments further after we get this mounted, depending on where my wife's foot pedal needs to end up. So we're going to put it together loosely and go from there. Now we're going to put these in the rocking brackets and mount it down to the bottom here using these bolts. Got four of them. It's important to get this part put together so we can mount it on the table properly, so we don't have to re-space the legs every time. And then we can adjust it later. Okay, now we're ready to flip this upside down so we can try to figure out where to drill the holes for the tabletop. We need to drill pilot holes to put in the desktop to hold the legs on. And I'm using a 1/8 inch bit, and I've put tape down half an inch to just drill a pilot hole. We just need to get the pilot hole started. We still want it tight, so grip tight. We got vibration on there. But this will give us a start, make sure we don't have any splits. So here we go. We got four for each leg. We want to center this front to back, and I've got it at 2 1/4 inches from the front. It comes out 2 1/4 inches from the back, and over here's the leg that I was worried about platforming. You don't want to interfere with the belt. You don't want to interfere with these other holes here. So you put it in between, and that's what I've done.
Now what screws are you using?
They are wood screws. Part of the kit, so the wood screws in there. Yeah. Well, they got real tiny wood screws. Word of caution for those putting this together. The wood screws that come with this to attach the legs to the table are very soft. They strip out easy. So if you're using a drill, not a good idea. I found that out the hard way. I had to replace them. But I have replaced them. They're in and we're ready to continue. So we got this in. The next thing is to get the wire switch down where it belongs. It's hooked to the motor already. And we're going to start placing that in. Next, we're going to mount the switch on, off, and the fuse holder. We want that up front. Then we can get the wire out of the way. The switch needs to be mounted first. We're going to mount it right here. We don't have to make it real tight, but you just want it snug so it holds it in place. Don't want to break anything, make it too tight. Now we're going to taunt the wire and put the holders, these holders, to hold the wire. You need to make sure it stays clear of the belt. You need to make sure we keep it clear of the belt area. The belt's going in here. Easier said than done.
It's a nail?
It's a nail. the cable going to the other side for plugging it in should also be held to the back. Now we're going to place the control pedal and hook the linkage to the motor. Here's the what actually pulls on the motor to give it the speed, that arm. We have this linkage which came with the motor, and this linkage which came with the table. This one's longer, this one's shorter, so we're going to see which one fits best. Gonna place the foot first. Now, talk to my wife, she thinks that's about right. And a nut. Four of these. Now the pedal has a linkage that goes on there. We're going to have to figure out where that's going to go to tie the linkage. This is where we're going to come into. Looks like either one of these linkages will be long enough. So I guess I'll use this one. I'll tighten this all up after we get it attached. We can make some adjustments. So. I'm going to use the Phillips head bolts with nut on the back to secure it to the pedal. Okay, I should have put the drawer in. I had it upside down before. I got carried away. So I turned back upside down to put the drawer in. And the drawer just takes 6 screws. Put in. We're done. We can flip it back over. The next thing is to install the oil pan, and you may have to do what I did and get out a Dremel tool or a file or something and make sure these will actually fit. I've done it some, but they will fit. You want them to be snug, but you don't want them to tear them up putting it in. Once you've got that done, these two pieces I had to work on and these two. You take your oil pan and I'm going to set it up to put in. I'm going to put these corner pieces on here. And on here, and here.
Show them they're different.
And here. You can see their corner pieces are different.
Yeah.
The big corner pieces go in the front, small ones go on the rear. Pardon? What? Go as far as I can when the battery dies, will stop. And you just kind of work them in here. Now we gotta, these are our hinges for the sewing machine so we can tilt it back. I'm gonna put that in place. That in place. And this is our kickstand for the sewing machine. We'll put that in place. So we have it tipped up to get underneath for oil. It goes in there. Now we're going to get the sewing machine out nets and we're going to tuck these into the sewing machine slots where they go, and then we're going to set the sewing machine in place. The hinges go on like that. Like this. Then we're going to tip it in place. This machine's kind of heavy, so.
there's our kickstand in place and our hinges. And now it's going to roll back as we need it. That's how it sits. Now while we're in here, we want to put in the plunger, which is the push-up for the foot for using the knee brace. We'll show you where that goes next. That goes right in here. You can operate the plunger thing, push it up and down. That's what lifts your foot. Okay, before installing the flywheel, I want to talk about something here. Where they drilled the lock keys in here, there's little burrs in there. And I use my chainsaw file, which is a fine file to file it out. You can use sandpaper if you don't have that. You know, medium grit, you don't want fine and take too long. Of course, would actually rough it up too much. So we got those out. Let's slide it on. It fits perfect after that. We gotta make sure it's flush here on the end. And it is. Now we've got the flywheel installed. We want the shaft flush with the flywheel in the end here. The belt, I'm going to start off with putting it in through here. And then we're going to crawl under the table. Okay, we've got the belt pulled down. We loosened this nut all the way up. In other words, it was down one all the way up. Give us some maneuverability we need. Get it on there, and then lower the nut, and a little bit of tension on it. Play this one. Now I got tension on that, that'll be fine. Okay, let's talk about this magnet a second. When you find your magnet, it needs to go on the bottom in the oil pan, and there's a place for it. So if you break a needle, it'll magnetize the magnet. We'll draw the needle there and you'll know where to find it and pull it out later. And it's in your bag here. It's actually stuck to spare needles on ours. I didn't see it at first. So we're going to pull that out and put the magnet in place before we forget about it. I'm going to tip the head back. And the drain plug is where the magnet goes. Now if you break a needle, it'll travel the flow down here and get stuck there. Next, we're going to assemble the belt guard, the bobbin. The first thing we need to do is put this stanchion in. It threads right in here, and it's got a screw hole for the belt guard. So I already did that. And we need to get this semi in place, get the belt guard in, and then we'll mark the mounting holes for this. Now this has got to go in around behind the flywheel and in between the belt. It's a little awkward with this whole thing. It's just get it started now. This piece lined up while it's still loose. Now we're going to temporarily put the screws into the belt guard, and then we're going to mark out where this goes. I got this in snug. Now we got to get this in where it goes. We need to line it up where it's going to ride against the belt. We'll be able to slide. This wheel has to get right against the belt. And what we're trying to do now is just place it. Because we've got to drill holes here and here to hold it. You want that wheel to line up on the center of the belt. Okay. I'm going to draw a line down the middle.
Doesn't have to be perfect right now because of the slides. I can't see anything. You big thing of holiness, that's in the way.
Yeah, I'll do it without that then.
Now do what you have to do.
Now we're going to find the approximate middle and we're going to put a cross there. And a cross here. And that's where we're going to drill our holes. Now we're going to take this apart and set up to drill. We've drilled our holes after we marked them. We'll put the screws in. It's still loose. We need to adjust it. You see how it adjusts now? That's the whole point. Now you want to touch the belt.
What was that flipping thing you just did?
For setting the bobbin wheel. You want it to rub against the belt when it's like that. So we're going to adjust it so we get a little tension on there. And we're going to tighten it. And then we need to make sure the wheel comes off the belt when we loosen it. And it does. So that should be set right. We can always tighten it a little later, just to give us an idea. It's set solid. This stanchion for our guard, we need to watch it when we're putting in the back guard, because it's got to ride over top of this curve. So we've got to make sure we mount that in properly. And I'm going to show you what I mean. That goes in like that. And we got to have it placed the right place when we tilt it back. That guard is going to ride over top. If it doesn't ride over top, you don't have it in the right place. I guess you can see that. Now I'm going to put it back. So that's going to mark approximately where we need it, which is basically all the way back on right there. So I'm going to mark my holes, drill it, and put it in place. Now that we've established our location, we need to mark a center line down here so we know where the variable is, and then a cross on there where the center is so we know where to drill. Same on both sides. Okay, now I'm going to move this out, and the cross part that I have here and here is where we're going to drill and put the screw, and that'll leave us a little bit of room to slide it back and forth. Now, the drilling portion on this is the same as the drilling for these screws. The same screws. I'm going to show you how that's done. I'm using a 1/8 inch drill bit. I'll put it right here in the cross section. You're going to drill it out like so. Clean the floor later. Now, put our cross section in. Our back guard. Line up one end and get the screws ready and put them in. Mm-hmm. And we're going to put a washer on the screw.
Show them the screw.
The screw of the washer. Can you see that?
The step.
Sorry, folks. That one's started. Now I got it. That piece is not snug. Just snug it, and I'm going to try it. I don't want to put it down too hard. Okay, now let's tilt the machine and make sure it's all functioning properly. And we have it.
Yay!
Next, we're going to put on the belt guard on the motor part on the bottom. And we're going to put it on just like that. Line up the screw hole. Put the screw in. And we've got one more screw to put in on the other side. And then the lower belt guard will be on. Now, our LED light is magnetic. It can go anywhere on the back here where it can reach for you to use. And it simply plugs in to the back of the motor right here. So you have power to the motor, you have power to that. Light is done. Okay, we're getting ready to put on the thread tower. I'm going to take the bolt and rubber washer off here. The bolt and rubber washer, I'm going to take off the end. Start putting this through the table. I'm going to put our rubber washer on, then our metal washer, in that order, and then our nut. And once we get the rubber washer and the metal washer on, we're going to thread it on there, making sure not to cut into our power cable here, because it's right there. You might have done yours a little different. Now that's snug. Now we need to put on, this is going to hold our spool holders. You need to find the height where you want it and put it on there. It's adjustable, you can adjust it later. Now we're going to put our thread guide on the top. You're the sewer, you think it goes this way? You get that? Now for the spool holder. That one had the nut and bolt on. This one doesn't have it on there. Anyway, the other one sits on and tightens right there.
But you can't use it because it doesn't have a nut and bolt.
Okay, before you use your machine, it's time to put the oil at the bottom.
It's easier said than done.
And getting in the oil thing is a challenge, apparently. You simply tip your head back, push, there you go.
It's a heavy machine.
Oop. There's that's your oil pan.
That's the wick.
Where's the fill level?
That's the wick. Okay, that's low. Right there, and there's high.
Oh, thank you. I see it's got another wick hanging from up there too. A little string looks like a lantern.
Yeah, that's the wick.
Yeah.
Oh man, holds quite a bit of oil, but I'm not going to quite put it to the high.
Well, I'm going to show them if I can. Oh yeah, it's halfway in between. You're not quite all the way to the high, but it's above the low, so that's good. Now we're going to tip the machine back down.
That's got a filter going up.
Yes. And now we're ready to thread and run.
Yay!
Overall, the assembly on this was straightforward if you're mechanically inclined. I've got some mechanical inclination, so I was able to figure it out. And I hope you can too now that we have a video for you.
please like and subscribe. And for more videos on this machine, ring the bell, please, because we will have other things to show off. How to use this machine. Thank you.